Hello students, today we are going to learn very good lesson 2.2, The Worth of a Fabric. This is the story of Tiruvalluvar. He was a great Tamil saint, poet. He was a very kind-hearted person and also a textile weaver. So students, get ready with your textbook and we'll start the story. Now first stanza, Tiruvalluvar was a great Tamil saint poet, he who lived more than 2000 years ago. Tirukural is the book of his teachings. He is a greatly loved and respected even today. So students, here the Tiruvalluvar was a great Tamil saint poet and he lived more than 2000 years ago. Also he wrote a book, Tirukural, and his teachings are accumulated in this book. Tiruvalluvar was a textile weaver. He wrote beautiful fabrics and saris and sold them in the market. People said that he never got angry, never used bad words, never shouted at anyone. And this Tiruvalluvar, he was a textile weaver and he wore beautiful fabric and saris and sold them in the market. And he was very kind person and never used bad words, never shouted at anyone. In the same town, there lived a rich young man. He wasted most of his time roaming around his friends. They often made fun of other people. Now in the same town, there was one rich man was also living in the same town where the Tiruvalluvar was living. And he was, this man was not doing any work, just wasting the time. Most of his time he was wasting and roaming here and there with his friends, okay, and making the fun of other people. I don't believe what people say about this Tiruvalluvar, said the young man one day. I'm sure I can make him angry. Come on, let's have some fun today. Now here what happened? One day, this rich man, young man, he came to know that about Tiruvalluvar's nature, that he never gets angry. And that's why this young man decided to go with his friends and make him angry. Now, what happened? So, the arrogant young man approached Tiruvalluvar in the market and picked up a beautiful piece of fabric. So this arrogant means very proud. This proud young man, they all with his friend, they all approached the Tiruvalluvar in the market and picked up the beautiful piece of a fabric. And what he did, he asked, that young man asked to the Tiruvalluvar, how much does the whole fabric cost? Then the saint named the price. Saint tell the price that 8 coins. Young man unfolded the fabric and tore it into 2 pieces. What's the price of this piece now? And this young man, this arrogant person, he tore that fabric into 2 pieces and again asked, now tell me, what is the price of this fabric? Okay. Now here you can see this Tiruvalluvar and this arrogant man and his friend in the picture you can see. 4 coins, the saint answered politely. And here the youth saw that he was not angry and answered politely. Means he was not angry, why you told my this fabric and all. No, politely he answered that what? 4 coins. The youth was taken aback. Why doesn't the man get angry? He thought. He then tore the half pieces into half again. And now, tell me the price, he asked. Okay. 2 coins was the answer. And Saint answered that. Now, the price of this fabric is 2 coins. Okay. So, this young man's aim was to make him upset and angry. So, he tore the pieces into half again and asked the price. But then also politely he answered 2 coins. Okay. Now it was the young man who became impatient and agitated. He tore the pieces into half again and again, saying, "And now, what's the price now?" And this young man was now became very impatient and agitated. Means become very upset. Agitated means upset. And angry. Why he tore the pieces into half again and again. And then also this saint not gets angry. Then the rich man was not successful in his aim to agitate, to make this saint angry. They were angry. So he himself became angry. Okay. He go on tearing the piece of the cloth until it reduced to the very small rags. Now Tirulam calmly went on reducing the price to the half every time. At last, the fabric was reduced to rags. So Tiruvalluvar said in a quiet tone, "Now this fabric has become worthless. I will not name any price for these rags." Now here this young man, he go on tearing the piece of cloth until it reduced to just rags. Rag means very small piece, thread. Okay. So he said that he refused to take money. He said, "No, now this is the worthless, means it's of no use now." Okay. The young man did not know what to say, but he was proud of his riches. So he offered to pay 8 coins to the saint. For the first time, Tiruvalluvar smiled, but he refused to take the money. So this young man, he was rich man was surprised that fabric was reduced to rags. Then also saint was not angry. So he young man said that, "Okay, I will give you 8 coins. Then also he refused the money. The young man, now this fabric is of no use. It has become worthless. Why? Because no one will be able to wear it now." So saint said that, "Young man, this fabric is now useless. Why useless? Because it's of no use." When young man asked, "Why are you refusing the money?" At that time he said that, saint said, "This fabric is useless. No one will able to wear it now. So don't give me money." "Do you know, the fabric was not made in a day. Many people have toiled to make it. The farmer who grew cotton in his field worked hard for months through the sun and rain. He picked cotton from each ball and gave it for spinning. Then someone else carded the cotton and spun it into long uniform threads. The threads were dyed carefully so that they took on these lovely colors. My wife and I wove the threads together, putting in beautiful designs. We thought someday someone will like this fabric, will be happy to wear it. Then all our work would have been awarded. When you destroy the fabric, you destroy all the love and the labor that went into its making. Money can't bring it back. Now here, we can see many new words are there. See here, T-O-I-L-E-D, toiled. Toiled means what? Work very hard. Okay. Now here, the saint said that many people work very hard to make this fabric. The farmer grew cotton in his field, worked hard for months through sun and rain. He picked the cotton from each ball. Ball, this again one word has come, ball. Ball means pod of a cotton plant, which contains the seed. So farmers, what they are doing, pick out from each ball and gave it for the spinning. Spinning means process of making yarn, or we can say process of making thread out of the cotton. Okay, now then next procedure is that someone else carded. Carded means clean and comb cotton to remove the seeds. Seeds are removed from that cotton. Carded the cotton and the spun, S-P-U-N. Spun means to make the thread, and in this way, thread, long thread form. Okay, uniform thread form. The threads were dyed, means colored, has given the color. Okay, and again the farmer was saying that my wife and I wove the threads together, putting a beautiful design so that someone will come, like it, may become happy and purchase it. Okay, so Thiruvalluvaran said that it was very hard working task to weave the fabrics. Okay, now and when somebody purchased that fabric, then all our work would have been awarded. Okay, and he said that when you destroy the fabric, you destroy all the love and the labor that went into its making. And this love and the labor, this task, this hard work, this can be bring it back by money. Money can't bring back. Okay, so the softly spoken words touched the young man's heart. Now he was really ashamed of himself. And do you know, Thiruvalluvar went on to say, I am weave another fabric like this. I can make another fabric also like this, no problem. But our life is also like this fabric. If you tear it apart with a hasty, thoughtless actions, it will be destroyed and you will not get it back again. Thiruvalluvar's words opened the young man's eyes. There and then he decided to give up his idleness and bad habits. Now here Thiruvalluvar said that even when an arrogant and the rich young man reduced his fabric to rags just to make him angry, he did not lose his temper. He refused to take money from the rich man because he said the rags were now worthless, useless. It was very, Thiruvalluvar told that it was very hard working task to weave the fabrics. Preparation of fabric required lot of days. When you destroyed the fabric, you destroy all love and the labor that went into its making. So money can't bring it back. So his softly spoken words to the rich young man opened the young man's eyes and made him give up his idleness, means laziness and bad habits. Okay, so dear students, you should not behave badly with, if people are bad in front of you, then also you should not behave badly with those bad people. You can change their bad behavior by your polite words and good actions. Okay? If you are good, be good. Hope you understood this lesson.